This is the Phoenix, Arizona weather discussion for Thursday, the 22nd of August. I'm Michael Graff. Another round of record heat in the valley yesterday, but we'll see a gradual cooling trend for the rest of the week and into the weekend as some moisture makes its way into Arizona. Will that translate into any chance of rain for us? And what about the weather for next week? Well, we'll talk about all of it. First, the almanac from yesterday, another record breaker, 114 degrees the high. That surpasses our old record of 110. The morning low is 85. That's a bit above average as well. Outside right now, here just after 8 a.m., clear skies out there. The sun shining brightly, 90 degrees at Sky Harbor. Dew points at 48, humidity 24%. The winds are light and the barometer is rising. Temperatures out there, 67 is the cool spot right now over at Fort McDowell. Most of us are in the 80s to near 90. The upper air look, very dry air continues across the southwest. Monsoon moisture nowhere to be found right now because troughing continues over the Pacific Northwest. Our ridge suppressed to the south and east, so a dry southwesterly flow. In fact, yesterday afternoon, the dew point at Sky Harbor Airport briefly dropped to 19 degrees. And in my 37 years of living in Phoenix, I've never seen a dew point in August get down into the teens here in Phoenix. Incredibly dry air. The watch warning map is pretty quiet, although we do have red flag warnings and fire danger concerns out here for much of the western states. Flash flood watches over parts of Kansas and Missouri. Otherwise, not a whole lot going on there. Convective outlook for today. The marginal risk of severe storms, the eastern Rockies, parts of the Dakotas, as well as from around Oklahoma City toward Little Rock, Memphis, Louisville, Kentucky, and much of the middle and upper Atlantic coast. The precipitation outlook valid through next Thursday morning from the WPC. Rain amounts here in the valley, probably nothing. And amounts between 0.5 and 1 inch for the southern border of our state. Parts of southeast and east central Arizona could see some spotty monsoon activity. But even that, not looking all that likely. And we'll detail it now as we check out the models. Here we go to the GFS. The 06Z run valid at 2 o'clock this afternoon. Troughing well to our north, a broad southwesterly flow continues. So down at the surface, another sunny day with low humidity. Highs this afternoon between about 107 and 110. Tonight with clear skies, the cooler pockets get down into the 70s. And here in the urban core, low to mid 80s. And then tomorrow should see an increase in humidity levels thanks to a Gulf surge. Some surge in low-level moisture due in part to showers and storms that fire up over Mexico, the Gulf of California, overnight tonight and into the early morning hours tomorrow. So we'll feel a bit more uncomfortable. The good news is that's going to drive temperatures down a bit. The bad news is the mid-levels of the atmosphere are still pretty warm and relatively stable. So only isolated showers and thunderstorms will be possible over the higher terrain tomorrow. We did have a chance of storms in our forecast for tomorrow evening, but I just don't think that the atmosphere will support that here for the south central deserts. The chance of rain isn't zero, but we're going to keep it out of the forecast. Highs tomorrow should be around 101 to 104. Then over the weekend, the humidity levels will remain up at least a bit. Partly cloudy skies for Saturday, highs 100 to 103. Same thing on Sunday, but the rain chances will be moving on out of here again. High pressure builds overhead, a fairly stable environment, an isolated mountain storm, and that's about it. Monday, kind of the same thing. High pressure building back in. Temperatures start to warm up, and we'll see the same thing on Tuesday. And Wednesday, a bit more moisture starts to seep back into eastern Arizona at that point for widely scattered showers and thunderstorms. But I think here in the valley, we stay dry and temperatures will head back toward that 110 degree mark by the middle part of next week. Gets a little bit more interesting as we go to a week from today. This is Thursday, the 29th. Indications of some more moisture coming in, but the upper high doesn't exactly get into the greatest position to bring in copious moisture, and it's a little too close to us. Still, the mid-levels of the atmosphere are probably going to be too warm and stable. Nevertheless, widely scattered showers and thunderstorms would be possible, and I couldn't completely rule it out for the valley by late next week, but with this monsoon season the way it's been, we're just going to have to take the wait-and-see attitude. And then going out 10 days, this is the end of the forecast period. Saturday, the 31st, as we get into the Labor Day weekend. And again, the ridge is around, but some monsoon moisture would be here, but just mixed messages from the models. The GFS has been more aggressive with bringing moisture in and chances of showers and storms. The Euro is drier, and so we will just have to see what happens out here. But the bottom line is below average chances of precipitation look likely to continue for at least the next 7 and possibly all the way out through the next 10 days, the rest of the month. All right, let's check out the QPF coming off of the European Ensemble through the period. And frankly, This doesn't look all that promising. A little bit of rain on some of the members, but we still look to stay fairly dry for the rest of August, and that bodes very badly for our dubious distinction of the driest monsoon on record. We will see. All right, the temperatures off the European ensemble through the period. We cool it off for the weekend. Temperatures go back up just a little bit for next week. And then trending down as we head into September. Again, I think it's a little optimistic to call for highs getting back down into the upper 90s. But we will see if that moisture increase comes to fruition or not. And that's going to do it for the Phoenix, Arizona weather discussion for today. My next video back here tomorrow morning. If you like our videos, be sure to subscribe so that whenever we post a brand new one, you'll get the notifications. Your comments, questions, and suggestions are always encouraged as well. Thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. Be safe out there and have yourselves a wonderful Thursday.